everybody. It's Mandy Webkinz and happy Halloween. I am here today with our friend Steve Webkinz.
Hello.
Hey, Steve. And of course, joining us is Michael Webkinz.
Hey, Mandy.
Hey, guys. So you know what? Lately, Michael, we've been posting a lot of stuff just as images instead of doing videos, but we thought it would be fun with Halloween coming up to do a special Webkinz Trendz video again.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah, and what do you guys think of my costume?
Ooh.
I know. This is the spooky ghost, and it's an older costume, but it's available at Ganz eStore, and I love it. It's so cute.
Very cool.
Yeah, and I think that might be the 2013 jack-o'-lantern I'm holding. I'm not sure, but yeah.
Love those jack-o'-lanterns.
Yeah, so cute. The glowing ones are neat. So let's get started. Now, this is Belfry the Bat by Elish. Aww. And oh my God, I have to say, that mask, I find a little scary. I don't know about you guys.
Yeah, I think it's one of our early Halloween gift masks that we gave out, the skeleton mask, which shows actually separate from the skeleton x-ray outfit there.
Okay.
Which works really well with a black colored capette there. It almost
it
looks like
really
it is an
does.
X-ray.
Yeah, it's really cool. But yeah. That's
really simple. Yeah, just two pieces of clothing to make a really effective costume.
So cute. Now, this is Blair's Witching Outfit by Peach Beach. And I love this because Blair has gone for that witch outfit and the glasses match the dress and then the Mary Jane shoes. But I love that she's got a ghost buddy.
Exactly. Always important to accessorize during Halloween.
Exactly. A black cat, a ghost buddy. What more could you want?
Is that a little shout out to Harry Potter, maybe? The circular glasses?
Yes, perhaps.
Very neat.
Perhaps this witch is a Hogwarts witch. Now, this is A Chemist by Lily Cat. And I love that Lily Cat, I think, has used ski goggles, right? Which sort of work as, if I'm not mistaken, are those ski goggles?
Yeah, I think
so.
Or
are those scientist goggles? Yeah, they work really well as sort of protective gear.
And then goggles?
Protective goggles.
You know what? We have a couple of scientist things, or at least like a mad scientist outfit, but I love that they've really combined four unique pieces of clothing, including that Dr. Quack's jacket, right, Steve, that to make a really cool costume.
Yeah, I like it. And really seems appropriate to have sort of like a white, snowy looking pet wearing ski goggles as a chemist.
Yeah, and you know what else? Those are the snowman feet, right? I think. But I love the fact they sort of look like those things you put over your shoes, those cloth things to not.
Oh, yeah, the little
spread.
Booties.
Yeah.
Safety booties are.
Yeah, this is a really clever costume. Now, this is a wacky costume. This is Citrus's Wacky Outfit by SFUP. And there are some great wacky outfits here. And then that wig is just perfect. Especially with that pet.
It's funny because with the eyes and then the wig, it almost looks like those aren't glasses, but actually the pet's eyes.
Yeah, it's really cute. And I believe that's the orange little spring bunny, if I'm not mistaken.
Cute. Yeah, I love the wigs that we've done. And yeah, like you say, those eyes are great. We actually gave them away in this past Wacky Zingo celebration.
This pet is totally transformed. That is an adorable look. And here is one of our new goblins. Is the description was Dot Goblin is so cute, and Ginny Rainbow is absolutely right. Dot Goblin is so cute. This is so colorful and fun.
He's actually looking a little gremlin-y to me, right out of the retro 80s.
Definitely, and really colorful.
Somebody fed this guy after midnight, I think.
Those glasses, those I think part of the new fall line, right? But glasses on that pet are super cute because they have such big eyes. So it sort of looks like they're wearing thick glasses that make their eyes look bigger. And this is Dottie's Pumpkin Fairy Queen outfit by Coco Beanies. And this is such a pretty combination. I assume the shoes and tiara go together, but I haven't seen that dress before. Do you guys know?
I'm not sure where it's from. I'm sure one of our pixie fairy type dresses things. I think the only thing I recognize, I think those are the Plumpies glasses, the very rare Plumpies glasses.
Which are really cute on that black and white pet too.
Well, we did a Pumpkin King and Queen costume.
Oh,
I think it was
right.
Last year. You could only get it through a floaty clicky event, and that could be the tiara that comes with the pumpkin queen and maybe even the shoes. But yeah, that dress, I'm not sure. That maybe it looks like a fall fairy or something like that. But yeah, as you guys say, it's perfect with the rest of this outfit.
Yeah, really beautiful. Now here is another goblin, and oh my god, again, so cute. And I know that is the toadstool dress and headdress, I believe, but those shoes, I'm not sure if they go with it, but they're perfect.
Those shoes have been around for a while.
Oh, okay.
They may be one of the ones from the outlet or somewhere pretty common, I think. I've seen them for a long time.
Oh, they're really pretty. And they're really cute with the flower. And again, we've got another pet buddy, the Zum here, which is adorable, floating next to this goblin. And here, I believe this is another new eStore outfit. This is Hope as a Pink Witch by It's Web Mom. And this hat, shoes, and dress were just released this month in Ganz eStore. And really, really fun. I love the spiders in the wig.
Yeah, I think this is the cotton candy
outfit.
And again, plumpy glasses. Very cool.
They work with everything.
Love those pointed buckled boots straight out of Wizard of Oz or something like that.
Yeah, striped stockings too are very witchy.
Yeah, and you see the spiders on the hair are a great touch, and they definitely are. But look at that. There's some spider webs right on the dress that are really cool.
Yeah, and it's perfect with this black pet again. The pink really pops.
Maybe they're licorice spiders.
Maybe. Hopefully. Because that's... Actually, spiders in the hair aren't ideal, let's face it. But now this is It's a Girl outfit by DJH89. And so adorable. I do love the soothers that we do, the pacifiers. And then they've paired it with the cute little diaper bonnet and that t-shirt. But the boots are an interesting choice for a baby.
Yeah, I was going to say the same thing. It's like very babyish and then very... Yes, very stylish boots. Of course, every baby needs a pair of very stylish boots. But I think, yeah, the soother works great, especially with a pet that has whiskers. It kind of really just makes it seem extra cute.
Yeah, it is cute. It's, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, Michael.
No, that's one of the baby uniform there, or costume, is one of the new uniforms that we have this year for Halloween. Still available in the Kinstall outlet. There's actually a bib that goes with it that you can wear. They've chosen the t-shirt there, though, but it's awesome because the pinks really pick up the rest of the colors in the baby outfit.
Yeah, and I have to say, like, real baby clothes, sometimes they do make shoes that, of course, a baby will never need to wear. So maybe they make some lacy boots for babies, too. Now, this is Magnificent by Bad Hockey. And this is a fabulous outfit. I believe that is the Fairy Queen headdress. And I am not sure where the shoes and the dress are from. I don't think that's the Fairy Queen dress.
But... No, the dress, I think that's a Dark Queen dress, maybe. And that was a previous Halloween costume. The shoes might go along with that as well.
The shoes kind of look like that new spooky gothic theme.
Maybe, yeah.
Because they've got the checkerboard pattern on the heel, don't they? Maybe.
And thank you to Bad Hockey for naming this pet Magnificent so that we don't get sued by Disney.
I know. I was like, oh, it's close, but it's more fabulous. Now, this is October's Pet of the Month, I believe, isn't it? The Spice Cat. And it's Melanie as a Butterfly by Lemony. And that dress, those little butterfly dresses that eStore does are so pretty. And then they've paired it with the tiara and those glittery shoes. And
the wings are just really fabulous on this dress here. And, the combination too with the sparkly shoes. The sparkly shoes, I think, are really a nice touch to give a lot of class for a pet.
Yeah, and the colors too really match. The pet and the wings really look nice together.
Absolutely.
Now, this is Mexia's Halloween outfit by Rocky5465. And maybe you guys can tell me, is this like a zombie princess or?
We did a zombie costume.
I know this year we did a zombie bride, but yeah, I think they
did a zombie girl version, because I think the one that we released as a Halloween costume previous year was a boy costume. And so I think maybe eStore made a girl costume to go along with it. But really, cool. Seems like, you know, maybe died in gothic times or something and then has finally made its way out into the world.
I think when we did the zombie costume, the original one, there was those green splotches as a face paint kind of thing. That was a thing more in the glasses slot. And then I think the eStore has done their version with the headband and having the face splotches as part of the headband outfit there.
Face paint really sort of transforms pets. It's really cool. So it looks adorable on that pet. Now, this is My Scarecrow Nora by Lexi2406. And I think that's a lion under there, which seems to be a perfect pet for the scarecrow outfit. The coloring is just right.
Absolutely. That was one of our previous costumes that were available this year through that jack-o'-lantern floaty clicky. So maybe Lexi2406 was lucky and picked up both pieces of the costume during that event.
Yeah, this is like a two-for-one Oz character here. The lion dressed up as the scarecrow.
Oh, that's true. I didn't think of that. You're right.
All it needs is ruby slippers or something, if we have them.
Yeah, we have ruby slippers. I'm pretty sure. Yeah. We have a whole bunch of jeweled
shoes.
A few variations on that.
Yes. Now, this is very clever. No. This is Bullseye Jingles 444. And this is Paddington Bear. And now, I assume that's a bear, although we do have some dogs that are kind of bushy, but I think that is
looks
bear,
like one of our signature bears, maybe.
Yeah, it's just, it really does capture the look of Paddington, I think. That coat especially.
Yeah, it's the perfect Paddington outfit.
Yes. Definitely. Mm-hmm. Now, this is Pumpkin Gal, and I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce this player's name, but it's XXYNCMXX. Now, they've used the pumpkin hat, but then they've mixed it with some nice clothing items that just work really well with it. Like, that sweater is fabulous. I don't know if you guys know where that one's from. I haven't seen it before.
No, maybe it's from one of our fall clothing bags. Could be. I'm not sure, but I think that jack-o'-lantern cap was also in one of our previous treat bags that we give away on Halloween. By the way, Halloween is only a couple days away, Mandy, so there might be a cool costume piece coming in a few days, so don't forget to log in on Halloween.
Definitely. Yeah, that pet looks so cute. This is Rufus as an Eager Beaver by Skippy Bradley. We all know where the Eager Beavers are from, right? They're from Webkinz World. So this is really cute because Rufus is the summer beaver, which gives it a bit of a pink flair.
He's very cute. He's got all of his worker outfit items there. And he's, I guess, going to be very nimble across the ironworks there because he's wearing ninja shoes.
And do you guys know, what is that belt?
That belt is from, we have the solar suit. We actually just replaced
that. Works really well.
Yeah, you could get pieces from Melissa's Star Challenge. Now there's the galaxy suit that matches the galaxy theme from the W shop. So it looks like a space suit. But we've had two previous ones, and that was from one of the past suits that you could collect.
Yeah. Well, make sure you go every day and try to click on the comments if you see them so you can get pieces of the solar suit.
Yeah, and you know what? It works well as sort of a tool belt because you could see that beaver hooking tools onto there. So I love it when players take an item that was meant for something and use it for something else. And as you said, Stephen, the ninja slippers sort of work as work boots here. And this is Snow White by Cakes? I'm not sure. But so pretty, and pretty on this pony, too.
That's great, yeah. I remember we promoted, was it Mirror Mirror, I think, the movie?
Yeah,
several years ago, and you could actually collect Snow White's dress. So that, I know, was really sought after. Really, really cool. And as you say, a Snow White portrayed by a Snow White pony. Really, really nice.
Yeah, really pretty. Now, this is Snowflake wearing Trick or Treat by, and I always call this person Gucci, because if you take out the numbers, it spells Gucci, so I hope I'm getting that right. And yeah, I love this candy corn hat and dress. And then I'm not sure if the shoes and socks go with it, but if they don't, they're perfect for it. But
yeah, I think this is all part of the same outfit.
Oh, nice.
I can't remember if it was all released at the same time, but I know like the candy corn witch costume has been around for a while.
It's so cute on that sheep.
Absolutely, yeah. That costume has been around, I know, for a while. One of my favorite of the witch costumes, though, because it looks so delicious, that hat. I just want to take a bite out of it.
Yeah, it's so adorable. This is King Frog by Perfect 29, and I love this because I'm pretty sure that is a cat under there, but you would never know because not only do they have that fabulous frog helmet on, but then with the monocle and the mustache, it's just hilarious.
Yeah, this is a real combination of outfits here. You've got the Martian coat, you've got, you know, a King Frog helmet kind of thing. You've got the goblin slippers, and the monocle is kind of an interesting touch.
It's very funny, very cute, very cool.
Yeah, it's a great combination. And our final one today, and I believe, Michael, maybe these are related to the same promo you were talking about. Some of them, I'm not sure, but these are Fairy Tale Characters by Shadowhunter 2015. The cat up in the top, they've got like the glass slippers mixed with the Snow White outfit, which is pretty. And I love this night suit at the bottom. And then there's like, looks like a Wicked Queen on the top right.
Yeah, the top two definitely were from, I think, a promo, third party promo. But the costume at the bottom there, the knight, that was last year's Halloween costume, one of the new ones that you could get. And it was also part of the jack-o'-lantern floaty clicky.
So that went along with the haunted castle, I guess, right? That's
right, great, yeah. I mean, yeah, it could for sure.
Yeah, I love this little storyline. I feel like he's the huntsman who's going to save Snow White.
An interesting effect, too, with these glass slippers on a pet that has one black foot and one white foot.
Oh, yeah, because the transparent slippers sort of looks like they're all different colors.
Great costumes. Wow.
Yeah, very cute. So, guys, we are so excited, and we're still getting more costumes in. I'm sure our next trends will include lots more costumes. But thank you to everyone who sent in a costume to us. And, Steve, what are you going to go out for Halloween as, do you think?
As a Webkinz game designer.
Oh, all right. And Michael?
Well, I think I'm changing my mind after seeing that Frog King. So I'm going to go with Frog King.
Michael like normally it. Has a monocle and mustache. Yeah. So it just makes
it's
sense.
It's true. All he needs is the frog helmet.
And the Martian hat and the goblin shoes.
But thank you, everyone. And we love your costumes. So keep them coming at webkinztrendz@gans.com. And thanks, Steve and Michael, for joining me.
Thank you.
Happy Halloween, guys.
Happy Halloween.